current dividing rule in parallel connection. So from this current dividing rule, we can find out the current passing through the elements which are connected in parallel. So here we are taking two resistance R1 and R2 which are connected in parallel. So total current I is supplied by the source. Now this current is divided into two parts. I1 current passing through this resistance R1 and I2 current is passing through this resistance R2. And here I is the total ampere current. So how to find out this current passing through this resistance R1 and R2? So if we know the value of total I, the value of resistance R1 and resistance R2, then we can find out the value of I1 and I2. Remember, to find out the value of this I1 and I2, you must be know the value of current I, because this current I is divided into two parts, I1 and I2. So it is most important. Now, first we find out the equivalent value of this resistance R1 and R2 which are connected in parallel. So already we have seen the equation for the parallel connection of the resistance. So from that we can write 1 upon R is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2. Take LCM R1 and R2. So equation becomes R1 plus R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Now reverse this equation, so we will get the equivalent value of resistance R is equal to R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Now the voltage drop appear across this equivalent resistance. According to Ohm's law, we can write V is equal to I into R. So here I into R. Now we can put the value of this R in this equation. So our equation becomes R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Now let me find out the current passing through resistance R1. So you can also apply Ohm's law here to find out the current passing through this resistance R1. So we can write I1 is equal to V upon R1. So V, it is nothing but the voltage drop or the voltage available across this resistance R1. And already we have seen that the in parallel connection, each and every branch having same voltage which is applied to this circuit. That means input voltage is equal to voltage available across branch 1 and branch 2. So here just V is equal to nothing but I into R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2, here into R1, R1 R1 cancel. So our equation becomes I into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Now similarly we can find out the current passing through this resistance R2 by using Ohm's law theorem. I2 is equal to V upon R2. Just put the value of this V in this equation. So I into R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2 into R2. R2 R2 cancel. So our equation becomes I into R1 divided by R1 plus R2. So from this equation we can say that, or we can write that, the branch current, it is nothing but total current into opposite branch resistance divided by the addition of resistance of both branches. Now from that we can find out the value of the current passing through this branch. Now this above equation, it is also applicable for the more than four branches or more than two branches, because here we are taking only two branches which are connected in parallel. But in practical or in practice, this parallel network having more than two branches. So here let me take one example how to find out the current passing through which four branches which are connected in parallel. So here you can see that resistance R1, R2, R3 and R4, they are connected in parallel. So I current, total I current is divided into four parts, I1, I2, I3 and I4. Now how to find out the current passing through this each branch? So first we can find out the equivalent resistance of this parallel circuit. So we, from that we can write 1 upon R is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3 plus 1 upon R4. Now take LCM R1, R2, R3, R4. So here for that you can write R2 into R3 into R4 plus for this R1, R3, R4 plus for that plus R1, R2, R4 plus R1, R2, R3 divided by R1, R2, R3, R4. Now reverse this equation. So we will get the equivalent value of this resistance R is equal to R1, R2, R3, R4 divided by R2, R3, R4 plus R1, R3, R4 plus R1, R2, R4 plus R1, R2, R3. Now first we find out the current passing through this resistance R1. So I1 is equal to, we can write V upon R1, and V is nothing but I into R divided by R1. So I into, put the value of this R into R1, R1, R1 cancel. So I1 is equal to I into R2, R3, R4 divided by R2, R3, R4 plus R1, R3, R4 plus R1, R2, R4 plus R1, R2, R3. Now similarly, we can find out the value of I2, I3 and I4.